Got new information on Tropical Storm Erin as it moves still to the west, and it will go west-northwest. Now, we're seeing different information as it reaches towards Turks and Caicos near the Bahamas. I'm seeing also chances for tropical storm impacts there. Also, a potential close call towards the east coast. Still sticking with my original forecast that is going to be a very scary turn, but by the skin, just get right on by. Showing that we still have a few things to watch out for. Plus, we have another strong wave coming off the coast of Africa that can go into the same direction. Some runs take it into the Caribbean. I'll show you the latest information. And over here for the Gulf is really ramping up for what's in those very warm waters. We have Invest 98L. It is moving northwest at 8 miles per hour, 22 miles per hour sustained winds. And some of the winds take it where it tries to become a tropical storm right there in the Gulf before it goes west. It has a lot of deep ocean heat. And it is actually strengthening over here. National Hurricane Center has it to where it's going to start doing that rapid intensification and get all the way towards 3 miles per hour shy of a Cat 4 with Cat 4 wind gusts. So it's going to be a very powerful storm here. In fact, the hurricane models is starting to see more of that southern track of that westward turn than a big abrupt turn right after that. So we have a new advisory for Invest 98L. It is at 20% in 48 hours, 20% in the next 7 days, which it won't make it. It'll be going on shore by Friday evening. But you could get locally heavy rainfall that is possible along portions of northeastern Mexico and southern Texas over the next few days. Showing the latest chances of a tropical depression has a good chance. It gets all the way up towards that 50, even at 60, almost at 70% chance of forming a tropical depression right here. Remember, this is where that deep ocean heat is as it's going towards that west northwest. And you can see the latest information on the chances for Erin to go further towards the west while we get that tropical wave that came from the Bahamas into the Gulf, spinning all the way around over here along the coast and acts almost like a guard. So pretty much you have a Panther's guard right here, giving it a little bit more shear in upper levels, just a little bit. And you can see right here that it does feel that tug from that system coming off. Now I'm over here in Wisconsin. We got the Green Bay, but I'm originally from New Orleans. So we have a Saints runner right here that's running north, and it's going to get a little shear right there before it goes further towards the north, and that trough comes in like a referee and just takes it right out the game. So far, that is still the forecast, but we have a couple pivot points that we need to watch. So you can see this here in pieces. So in 72 hours, you have Invest 98L. And as we go 4 and 5 days, it does get a little bit shear as it starts going up that weakening high pressure. It does eventually weaken down. And as you go 6 and 7 days is where it makes that turn with that trough taking right on out. Then as you go 9 and 10 days, another wave showing is going to come almost in the same direction. This is still too far to know this for sure, everyone. It's been going this way. It's been going this way. It all depends on the position of the high pressure once again. So what we do know, temperatures are very warm in the Gulf for Invest 98L as it travels towards that west-northwest. Also, what's building up over here for Erin as Erin goes on his journey as well. Latest information on the deep ocean heat content, you can see over here for Invest 98L. It has a lot of deep ocean heat it could tap into. So once it starts spinning around and rotating and upwelling the temperatures, it's going to upwell some very warm temperatures right close to landfall right before the end of its run. And you can see the path for Erin as well. Very warm waters down below for it to tap into. This is going to be a very big and a very broad system. Seeing a little bit of a northward shift in the ensemble, as a matter of fact, of what Invest 98L could do. Seeing it in 24 hours getting off into the Gulf, the southern Gulf. In 48 hours, the members are in a good agreement that it will be going somewhere towards southern Texas, more than towards northern Mexico. But still showing it will go on that strengthening phase by a lot of these members, but still showing more than likely will just be a tropical depression. It will run out of time over land. But the stronger this gets, the more tropical moisture is going to swing into Texas. Showing it will go up and down, maybe even by this afternoon. It could be already tropical storm strength, but then get whittled back down again. So it's showing that it's going to have problems right before it goes towards landfall, but showing it could bring some winds on shore for southern Texas as this comes on land for Friday. So far, not showing a lot of rainfall, maybe a quarter to a half an inch, and there will be isolated areas that will get an inch, maybe a little more from this. It all depends how big the banding actually gets. Still showing Erin will come close towards the Leeward Islands, also towards Puerto Rico and Dominican Republic, bringing you some tropical storm force winds. Showing for the biggest part, you could get some wind gusts in the high 30s, maybe even portions of 40s as it swings by, but starts picking up in intensity as it goes by Puerto Rico with y'all 30, 40 miles per hour wind gusts, maybe some 20 and 30 miles per hour sustained winds. Those are a little bit weaker, but still, it's almost tropical storm impacts. And you see, as this goes further towards the west, this is where it gets more intense over here towards Turks and Caicos, towards the Bahamas. Showing for the next 3 to 5 days, you could get anywhere from 1 to 3 inches of rainfall for the Leeward Islands, Puerto Rico. Also, when you go further down the Lesser Antilles, you could get another half an inch of rainfall for those islands as well. Now, GFS takes it on a different angle than the European, and seeing those 2 inches of rainfall rates go further down the Lesser Antilles. Just be aware of that. Agreeing that once it goes past 3 days, it will still be somewhere in this vicinity. Then once it goes 4 days, it starts changing. But what you have noticed is that these hurricane models, which is made with better data to figure these waves out, is showing a little bit more of that westward push versus that turn already. Showing a lot of members still showing we could get anywhere from that major hurricane towards that Cat 4, maybe even a high-end Cat 4, and that'd be right around towards the Bahamas area. We also have another group that's showing it could just stay a Cat 1 or a Cat 2. Now, the hurricane hunters are flying in 4 o'clock this evening, and they're going to find out all the drop data that we need to get better information into these models, everyone. So I think we'll have a way better picture and a way better look at what the possibilities are as we go into this afternoon when we get that information. In the long run, National Hurricane Center confirms this as well, that there is still a greater than normal uncertainty about what impacts Erin may bring to portions of the Bahamas, the East Coast of the United States, and Bermuda in the long run. But they are agreeing that GFS is on the eastern track and the hurricane models is on the western track. Shown by the ensembles at in 72 hours, more likely will still be way far enough away from Leeward Islands, still tropical storm possibility impacts. And you see how the confidence grows as it takes that westward push as it goes towards 5 days. That right there is towards 5 days. Instead of being way out here really close towards the islands, it could be just far enough away where you would not feel too much of the winds. Then as that goes around, this is by the European Ensemble Prediction System, it starts losing confidence as it starts making this turn. Now you can see the same thing with GFS. It's just a tad closer, but still far enough away. Still getting that green where it has a lot of confidence where it more likely will be. Now once you get right here, you are at 5 days, so it's already getting too far away. If you look at the new update, the 6Z, actually takes it further towards the west, and that takes that a little tighter and a little further up the Bahamas and goes real close towards the U.S. Now that's 168 hours, that is 7 days. The previous run had it further up here. So if it goes a little bit slower, that's kind of what we're looking at. The latest hurricane model, you can see right here what analysis B, takes it all the way down to a 932. Once you get past Monday, this is where it starts going towards 5 days. Also, it takes it very strong winds. It goes all the way into the 150s. This is a very powerful storm, but if you watch it, you'll see that the intensity goes up and down. It don't stay steady at 150. Still a very powerful system. Still showing really close to the islands. Could be still a major hurricane. And that's what it does. It goes further towards that westward push rather than that quick turn because that extending high pressure blocking that tug. Showing that by Monday, you could see a lot of wind gusts over here towards Turks and Caicos getting up towards that 40, that 50 miles per hour wind gust. As you go through for Tuesday, it's going to move further up towards the Bahamas. Now you can see also with your wind speed that you're still getting possible tropical storm impacts along Turks and Caicos. Then as it moves towards Bahamas, it starts giving them potentially tropical storm impacts, a little bit stronger of tropical storm impacts with higher wind gusts as well. Now you get into the 60s and this moves a little bit closer. It just gets even stronger. But after that, by the time we go towards Wednesday, is where it's gonna make its big turn, bring a lot of riptides, a lot of big waves, but no impacts towards Florida. Then as it goes by the Carolinas, that's where it's going to be a little bit east or a little bit west. Showing went to Euro ensembles as it goes 6 days. More likely we'll make that very tight turn and be well offshore, everyone. You can see the latest runs that took it even closer. Not showing it that close, but still, we're talking about a very big and broad system. There still will be some kind of impacts. But good news for that for Bermuda is taking it further and further to the west. Now the old ensembles of GFS is taking it around the corner as well, where it should be far enough offshore, but you still could get some impacts maybe on the coast of the Carolinas as that pushes away. Now once again, this right here is 7 days, and the latest update takes it further towards the west right there as that travels by. Still turning very sharp, so it don't threaten the northeast, but still showing the threats could lie somewhere along the Carolinas and Virginia. Showing by the latest for the European that as it goes further towards the west, you still have that strengthening high pressure continuing to push that towards the west. And then the high pressure is going to weaken down, allow this to travel north a little bit. Then here comes that trough. That trough is going to act as that referee. It's going to call the game. No more passing, no more blocking, just get on out the game. GFS is seeing that close as well. Still far enough offshore where the impact should be minimum, except for the rip currents. The rip currents are definitely going to be very dangerous as that gets pulled out. That part is trending between the Euro and the GFS now. Even the icon, which showed a very scary run this morning, having it very close towards the islands and going into Bahamas even deeper, bringing it up the coast. Now, we go by the latest 5 days. That's as late as you can go for the update. The update shows it a little bit further away, showing so far the worst case scenario, you could see tropical storm force winds of 20 to 30 miles per hour sustained along the coast of North Carolina, and you could see a little bit stronger wind gusts go a little bit further inland. So this is by 4 p.m. as we go towards 7 p.m., not moving much. This is the latest run by the European, bringing 40, 50 miles per hour wind gusts, maybe on the coast of the Hatteras, maybe getting 60, but your actual wind speed is possibility of minor tropical storm impacts. But you got to imagine the waves as well. Showing the wave height has gotten a lot better for the Leeward Islands. You might see somewheres around 6 to 8 foot waves coming by for the islands all the way towards Puerto Rico. Then as it goes towards Turks and Caicos, it could dig in a little bit where you could see anywhere from that 6 to 10. Then the latest run showing it will miss the Bahamas with a lot of big waves, but you still could see anywhere from that 6 to 8 or that 6 to 10 foot waves as that swings by. So far showing very minimal for Florida and South Carolina, maybe digging in for North Carolina, getting a little bit more on the waves. Showing around Wednesday to Thursday is where it could dig in the most, where you could get anywhere from 10 foot waves, maybe 12 and 14 foot waves right offshore, but that will come on as well. So just be aware of this as this goes up towards the northeast. You could see some stronger waves push towards the coast. Definitely got some very strong waves coming, some very powerful riptides, so be very careful of that. So far, the track is looking like it could be a narrow miss. Just like I said before, a skin of your teeth, scary turn. Plus, we still have two more waves coming, everyone. You can see this with Erin turn, the latest projections from the Euro. And as you see the next two waves coming, showing they're still having problems with any kind of formation, could we still have that sinking air? But you see how it could bring a wave into the Gulf. And you can see with the Euro AI showing that after Erin, you could get one going towards the East Coast, just like Erin. And then the next one bringing a wave to the Gulf. We don't know which way those waves are going just yet because it's still too far away. It could go towards the Atlantic, it could go towards the Caribbean. But what we do know is that we have sinking air, and it's going to make it very hard for these to form. So I still think that we need to watch for close to home formations along the East Coast and in the Gulf. Still showing we have this big pocket of unfavorable conditions that's moving in all the way until the beginning of September, then slowly start changing from the beginning of September into our peak of our hurricane season, showing it could go all the way towards the end of September, maybe even into October, really strong. And right now, Erin is looking really good. It is doing a lot of intensifying. Matter of fact, you can see these white pieces right here. This is called cool tops. This is where it's getting a lot of deep convection. So it is growing very nicely, and it should start strengthening. I think it's going to start getting itself vertically stacked. It's going to slowly get away from the shear, and we're going to start seeing some intensification on this storm. But if you look at it, it's actually taking it right on the outside of A-Bear's box. You see that? right on outside on the latest track. So we will see what the wiggle is and what the updates are this afternoon. Make sure you subscribe and click the bell. When you click that bell, make sure you select all. That's very important. Before I go, a quick word from our Father, everyone. Matthew 22:37-40. This is when he asked Jesus, what is the greatest commandments, the greatest laws, everyone? Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Hope you all have a very great Thursday out there, everyone. I will see you this afternoon for the latest information with all the data and what we can expect for the rest of this hurricane season as well. Remember, above all things, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everyone. I'll see you this afternoon.